Welcome students to Principles and Practice of Management. This unit is done by a variety of students. It's done by ICT students, business students, nutrition students, and hospitality students. The reason that all of you do this unit is because it prepares you to become managers. It prepares you to be able to manage a group of people, okay? It has a lot of things that we learn under it. It's usually a very wide topic. It has a lot of notes. Therefore, I want you to make a point of being very fast in writing the notes. We are supposed to be having 4 classes, but we had to reduce them to 3 to accommodate most of you. For the evening students, we'll be having just 2 classes, where we'll, the evening class and a Saturday class, where we'll be doing a Zoom class. For the day students, we'll be having three day classes, where one of the first 2 classes will be the note writing, and the 3rd class will be having a video class like this, either a Zoom class or a video class, where you have notes and a video at the end. Okay, let's just go through what we'll be required to cover under the principles and practice of management. Also, the CHRP, the professional course students, will also be required to do this unit. So let's talk. The first thing that we'll do is the introduction to management. What is management? Why do people have to do management? You can think of management as a noun or as a verb. Management can be, you can tell people the management has decided this, or you can say this is the management of A, B, and C. We'll talk about that much when you're into the notes. And I think under the notes, you've already discussed a few things on what management is. Then under the second topic, we'll talk about the approaches to management thoughts. These are the different theories. These are the different theories that are used. These are the different theories that are used to discuss management. And then after that, these two topics are usually the main, they are usually the main part of management. And therefore, after that, we'll come and discuss the different functions of management. That is, what are managers supposed to do? They're supposed to plan. They're supposed to be able to organize. They're supposed to direct, to staff, to control. Okay? So under the planning function, you plan whatever should be done in the firm, where you have the short term, the long term, and the medium range term plans. Then in the organizing function, it is the job of the manager to come up with some organizational skills or to decide how the company shall be organized, whether the company shall have different branches and so on. Then usually have the directing function. This is also called the leading function. Remember, a manager has to be able to conduct some leadership. And at this point of the directing, we'll talk about what's the difference between a manager and a leader. Then we'll talk about the staffing function. It's the job of the manager to decide which types of staff do we need. Do we need staff A or do we need staff B? Then we'll talk about the control function. It's the job of the manager, or as the management team, you need to come up with ways to control whatever is happening in the business, to control the use and misuse of resources. And finally, talk about the emerging issues and trends in management. Now, this is one of the units that where most students usually get distinctions. Then you may be having a problem with the other units that relate to your course, but this course, as you can see, it's rather a simple course that requires you just to master a few points, where maybe you may be asked, what are the 5 functions of management? They're already some of the topics. You may be asked some rather simple questions, so you're given a scenario, you're told maybe someone was late, as a manager, what do you do? So this is one of the units where people get distinctions and credits, and I believe with the right amount of dedication, the right amount of asking questions, with the right questions of asking about you need past papers and so on, at the end of the course you'll have your very nice credit, you'll have your nice, very nice distinction. Now, always feel free, we have our WhatsApp group that has been linked in the portal. Feel free to use that link to get into our classes. We'll have one cut, one end of semester, and a number of assignments or end of personal assignment that I'll be posting because of the past papers. You cannot do all this within those 12 weeks. Remember, the course is taking 12 weeks. Therefore, Within those 12 weeks, you'll be required to cover so much. This is one of the units that has a lot of notes. So make sure you start writing your notes. The guys that usually prefer not writing the notes may have a problem because some of these things you need to write them down to remember them. Thank you, and let's have a great semester. I'm so sure by the end of this semester, you'll feel like it was a time that you spent very well. So let's meet in class. This is your first video. You'll have a number of videos, actually 12 videos for all the weeks. We'll be having our Zoom lessons and so on. Thank you and have a great semester.